Well, hello everyone. Cloud Chief here, and I'm getting ready to start my Let's Play of Dot Hack Infection. I'm still getting set up, so give me a second. Alright, about ready to get started. This is actually a pretty interesting opening. I definitely don't remember it, but I've only played through the Dot Hack series just once, because they are pretty long games. It's definitely an interesting opening that grabs your attention. But before I jump in, I just wanted to mention I made a video that basically covers Dot Hack Sign, which is an anime that started before this. If you're watching the live stream, just continue watching. I'll probably give away spoilers, and there's going to be things that are said in spoilers. If you're watching this on my YouTube channel, not live, since I'm recording it and upload it later, I recommend going and checking out the video. I'm trying to think what I named it. I think it's What You Should Know About Dot Hack Sign Before Playing the Games. But the nice thing is, because it ties into the anime really nicely. I remember, the beginning of this is weird. I guess they're reading the Epitaph of Twilight. Turn the Shadow Wand, who quested for the Twilight Dragon. Rumble the Dark Elf and Helva, Queen of the Dark, has raised finally her army. Yeah, the Epitaph of Twilight. It's interesting too, because I believe the Epitaph of Twilight was supposed to be written before the world was ever created. And just even the fact that it's talking about Helva.
User registration is done. Now for a name. Yasuhiko's probably already there waiting for me. I'd better hurry.
I'm just gonna leave it at Kite. A username? Alright. We will do Cloud Chief. No, we'll keep Kite. Yes! Like that, username is approved. As if it would get disapproved. Actually, that would be interesting. I honestly should go back and try. See if putting in dirty words actually lets you not do it. Now, The whole point of the Dot Hack series, it's supposed to be set up that it's an MMO. So, like, this is supposed to be the desktop on my computer. I can look at mail. Yeah. I think they're just explaining, yeah, thank you for registering. They're just explaining the basics of the game. And this guy's actually supposed to be one of the legendary characters. Well, I'm just gonna clear out these news. Alright. Let me just check real quick. I like blue better. And yeah, haven't unlocked any sounds yet. So, let's just get right into the story. Well, we can access the board, the message board or forums later. And Mac Anu. This is just the main root town. There he is. Orca.
Hey, you made it. Hey, it's me, Orca, the Blade Master.
Whoa! You look so different from the real Yasuhiko. Nothing like the real you.
Hey, in this game, I'm Orca. Regardless of what I am in real
And he's supposed to be one of the legendary characters. Him and another character named Balmung ended up defeating some enemy that was said to be undefeatable. And because of that, they both became legendary characters.
No, you look great.
Was it Orca of the Azure Sea? This is full name.
Anyway, take this. Member address is the Flashmail address. You can only...
That's basically so I can invite him.
Try it out. But
yeah.
First, press the triangle button to open the menu.
I got it.
In the menu, select party. Next, names. Choose a Cynthia. Now.
Got it.
Ah.
Sweet.
Hey, my name appears under your screen. By the way, Flashmail in. Oh, and you can't contact people when they're not locked. People do have a life, you know. We're not online 24/7.
Well, technically you are after you, like, finish
in
the game.
In other words, you can't always count on the same members to form a party.
But it is true, they have people go in and out.
You'll have more fun that way.
Besides, like, the gameplay actually being paused if you go into the menu, it kind of does do a good job, at least for... I think this game came out in 2003.
Well,
so for back then, it is set up a lot like an MMO would be. Besides, like, the menu...
Okay.
Freeze.
Well, why don't we head off? There's nothing to worry about. I found a perfect place for newbies.
Perfect place for newbies.
This is the Chaos Gate. Now...
You have to use the Chaos Gate to transfer between worlds.
An area. Select... This is the keyword screen. You put the three selected keywords one by one for
yes.
each part. Left of the entry plate is all the keywords you have. You can collect more of them by reading your emails, the board. Now, let's enter some keywords. Select bursting. Good. Next for part B. Select past... For the last one in part C, now you're done specifying the
area.
There
we go. It is pretty cool how they built this. Just by changing a word changes the entire area. You know, what monsters are there, what level it is, the element of the field.
One more thing. You see the symbol on the left next to the keyword? That's the server symbol. It indicates which server you are currently logged on.
And yeah, different servers will take you to different areas.
This symbol is Delta, so we're logged on to the Delta. The list on the bottom right is the area status list. See the jewel next to the field?
Yes.
That indicates how the selected keyword affects the status. For example, check the field type. See the jewel on the right?
I wish I could remember.
This means that the field type is being determined by aquafield, the keyword in C. We don't know what kind of field the current keyword will create until we get there. But once we learn the effect of that keyword, we can combine it with other keywords effectively.
Interesting.
For more details, check out the board on your... Alright, let's select...
I wonder what the different colors mean. I know I used to know Once Upon a Time, but... The game's not too complicated. It's pretty easy to pick up.
Before we get going, let me explain to you about the camera.
During the game,
enemies will attack from all directions. The idea is... I'll explain more later. Basically, if you don't use the camera right...
Yeah, but that's almost any game.
Rotate the camera. Push either the L1 button or the R1 button to move the camera.
Got it. Come on, Orca. I did.
Good. Next, let's zoom in. You can zoom the camera in or out by using the right analog stick. Try it.
I got it. We go a little faster, Orca?
Yeah, that's it. Finally, you reset the camera by pushing the R. There you go. Remember, when the battle starts, constantly adjust your camera.
Constantly adjust your camera in battle.
Okay. And this is the field. It's the lowest level in the area. When you want to return to the town, press the triangle button and select gate. Grassland, wilderness, and jungle are some of the field types. You can set them. The combination of field type and weather determines the area element. For example, if it's a grassland and it's raining, that area... The elements also affect... The
elements are pretty basic.
...and the items you can get. Don't worry about it now. As you get used to it, combine... Now, let's get going on our quest. First, you see the red down arrow on it?
That's the dungeon.
In the dungeon's deepest level, there's a god statue. Basically, the goal is to reach... But enemies are often tougher down there. So gain some level. Okay, wait...
Okay, use the fairy orb.
The fairy's orb. Hidden data on the map becomes visible. Yellow.
Yes, let's go pick a fight.
For a basic attack, approach the target and press the attack. By the way,
because the enemies would just sit still.
So that you can try using. Let's try using skills. Press the triangle button to open the menu.
Yes.
And select skills. Okay then. Choose Riff from the list.
What?
When the target cursor appears, select the target and press the X button to exit.
Okay.
You can target a party member for...
I'm not sure why it was kept scrolling to the left, but
remember.
Come on, let's get out of tutorial mode. That's the only problem with RPGs.
You must be sick of me at this point.
Yes, I am.
It's your turn to tell me what to do by using chat command. Okay. Okay then. Press the square button. Next. Go.
There we go.
Well, it's good to be the boss, isn't it? If you use it well, you can bunch up on the enemy or give separate order.
It is nice to be able to just tell your party members what to do and they do just do it. But again, that's an aspect that really wouldn't work in an MMO. I mean, you can ask them to do it, that doesn't mean they would. Alright. I'm gonna say an Orca will just take it down in one hit. Luckily, XP's not scaled, and I don't think we have anything to throw in here. You have nothing to throw in. Thanks, Orca. Take him out one hit. This is a level 1 field, and Orca is level 50. Alright, so let's head up the dungeon. It's funny, they said you should get some levels. You should get some levels if you're gonna do it solo.
Now we can start exploring the dungeon. One thing you need to remember is that you can't gate out when you're in a dungeon.
But you can use a Sprite Ocarina to warp out.
Gate out and return. The Sprite Ocarina
yes.
will warp. This is the trick. You should know that there are two types of treasure boxes.
There's trap boxes.
Normal. This one's normal. Hit the.
We gotta resurrect so we can bring someone back to life.
This one's booby trapped. Notice a different color? Try to open it as is. Just use the fortune wire on it. This. See?
Just use an item on it and the booby trap's taken off. Was it the first dungeon? Wow. Well, here we go. You're jumping right in.
What the? Did you just see that?
Yeah. Was that thing chasing her?
It was.
Yeah, but something like that on this level?
Skaith was ordered to go get Aura. Hi, puppy. I'm a little busy right now. Before we go to the left, see if there's an item over here, because in typical video game fashion, nothing happens until you get there. Even though it wouldn't
better watch out. We're trapped
real.
In here.
Uh-oh.
In the dungeon, there are rooms with traps everywhere. The only way to get out of a trap like this is by activating all the magic portals in the room. All right.
Really?
Let's charge to that.
Let's just let Orca kill them all while I have them. Free XP. I don't know if I want to keep going down. Could have swore. It's not good of a memory, but then again, it was a long time ago. I thought it was the second dungeon that basically what's about to go down. And goes down. I could have swore you just, you know, went to a dungeon, did everything, and then. Yeah. Okay, maybe it is. Huh. Don't try too hard. Don't worry, I'm not. I'm just letting you go up and one-shot enemies. The one thing that I do like about this, unlike other MMOs, or other MMOs, I mean, other RPGs, XP is per level, it's static. 1,000 XP to level, regardless of what your level is. But XP is scaled to enemy levels. Hence why, like, Orca's getting 1 XP and I'm getting 60. Here. Yeah, 60 and he got 1. So, okay. XP is given per kill in this. That's pretty cool because in GU, it's only given after the battle. So if you, like, kill two enemies and then run away, you don't get the XP. But apparently that's not the case for this one. Ooh, these guys are annoying. Yeah. I just remember there's mage goblins are pretty tough. I thought you don't have any wires. Strike an arena. I don't think I have a fortune wire. Oh, I do. Okay, wait, is it level 3? Okay, twin blade, so I can use it, but I need to get 2 levels. That's pretty cool. Already have armor, though.
This is the room where the statue is. There's only one of them at the dungeon's deepest level. That's enough adventure for now. Let's grab... If we had a Sprite Oak Arena, we could warp out of here. So we gotta go back the way we just came.
Actually, I believe I do have a Sprite Oak Arena, but... Oh, you get 3 items? That's something else that I didn't remember. Sweet. And I learned Tiger Claws with it, too. I think... Or no. Oh, I'm losing Saber Dance and getting Tiger Claws. Wow, so stuff does go down. I could have swore stuff went down in the second dungeon, but... Just jump right into the story. Now, this is a cool part.
Or was the rumor true?
Take this. Please take this. There's no time. Please.
What's this?
A great force. The power it holds can bring forth either salvation or destruction at the whim of the user. It's coming.
Run away!
Run! It'll kill you! What the hell?
Hey, your diesel friend just got his butt kicked. Yeah, you're a newbie, you just started, and you just watched your friend just get annihilated. And, yeah, he got data drained, so he ended up in a coma. Which is how the whole game starts. We'll find that out in a second. Was it the Book of 1,000 or something like that? And there's Helba.
What was wrong with Yasuhiko? Why was he upset? I wanted to ask him, but he wouldn't even pick up the phone. And then, the next day, I found out that Yasuhiko had been hospitalized. I rushed to the hospital, but they wouldn't even let me see him. But I guess it's better this way. I didn't want to see him all week, and he wouldn't want that either. But what the hell happened to him? I have a feeling that the key to it is somewhere in the world.
So Orca's now become a lost one. And that's basically how, you know, we go from here and try and save him. That's how the game all starts. You know, we can't access the other servers. I'm gonna access the board.
I should post on the board about Yasuhiko. Maybe someone will respond to it.
Okay, I didn't think I was going to be the only message on the board. Whoops. Just gonna kind of blow through all the messages. Luckily, they made it easy to get through all the messages in, GU. You can just go through here and get keywords and stuff like that. It also gives you good information, at least for learning, yeah, how things work. Yeah, play knowledge. $20 million. That'd be a lot of people to play a single game. I'll have to look up how many people actually play WoW, since I know WoW's the big MMO. Actually, what is this? Throwing the weapon into the spring of mist in the area. There it is. Because, yeah, this was the one thing I couldn't remember. Because you throw it in, and then they also... There's something about, yeah, gold axe and silver axe. Sure wasn't involved. I don't think it really matters what kind of field you're in. When it was cloudy, my armor got weaker. But when there was thunder and rain, my armor got stronger. People do collect it, some Tim want to trade for it. There are a couple more like him. Oh, you can use golden axes to trade, but collect the golden and the silver axes at high levels. I guess that's what it's for, is trade value. Because you can actually get a lot of good gear trading. There's a lot of... There are a lot of times in here you just don't want to sell your gear. You want to keep it just so you can trade it. Especially if you're finishing up. All servers are currently... Ah. So, nothing to do, I guess. You know, we log out. Should be able to log back in shortly. Like a real MMO, there's maintenance whenever you want to play. There we go. It's a book. It's trying to read it. It's obviously Aura, and she's saying please to the one. Was something the book? Yeah, I. Can't make it out! I believe. Okay, it's still there. So you get a strange email and then you can magically log in. I thought more time passed before all this stuff went down. I guess not. It had been a long time since I played this game.
What? What is it? You got something to say? No. Oh, I get it now. You are a newbie, aren't you? I might have guessed. Well, are you or not? Come on now, don't be shy. You can tell me. Listen, in case you're not aware of it, you're being very rude. It's impolite to stare at someone like that. You have to understand it's the same as the real world. Don't you get it?
I think the one being rude is the one that just ran up and started yelling at you.
What is up with you anyway, huh? Come on, will you say something already?
I know they wear visors and everything, but can you really know when someone's staring at you in the game? Alright. Let's see, I believe you... Yeah, save here. This is items. Since I only have 1,000 gold, I'm gonna hold off. How many items? Oh, I can store 99 and I can hold 40 items. Sell it for money or trade. Well, it's nice that they give you so much space. That's not something you would get in an MMO. You definitely wouldn't start off with 40 item slots and then 99 spaces. Okay, these are just scrolls. Don't really... Most of the time I sell scrolls or just use them for trading. Let me see if there's anyone worth trading. Okay.
Hmm.
See, now this is actually worth trading for. I don't think I'll be able to get it, though. Yeah. I didn't even get one star. You have to get it so all four stars are lit up and he's willing to trade. So that was like a rare item. And rightfully so, considering it just permanently ups your stats. But that's why you always want to keep items around for you to trade. Yeah, you have a lot of high level stuff. Alright, I think, yeah, we need to get some levels and stuff.
Wait a sec! Yeah, you! I know some interesting keywords. If you go with me, I'll tell you what they are. Do you want to know?
No, because I think I got it. Is it hidden, forbidden, holy ground?
Right on! That's the spirit! Spoken like
Hidden Forbidden Holy Ground is thrown all over Dot Hack. It's, was it, Hull's Grand Cathedral. Alright, party. Let's add Black Rose. 10 XP over his level 50. And she's calling us a newbie when she has 0 XP in level 1. Was it word list? Yep, here's where things get interesting. No. Just gonna run ahead. And this is pretty cool, like, cutscene, everything going down here.
You didn't even need my help at all, did you? That statue, it looks so sad.
Yes, Aura all chained up. First three parts of the wave.
I guess you can tell that I'm a newbie too. Yeah, it must be pretty obvious by the way I acted back there.
Also obvious by your level.
But you still hung out with me. You know what? You're nicer than I thought. You see, I'm trying to find...
Hey, what are you doing?
What?
Here we go.
What about you, huh?
No time to explain. It's too dangerous here.
What?
I'm telling you to get out.
Balmung of the Azure Sky. It's basically Orca's partner.
This one as well.
Why is it glowing like that? It's so freaky. Is this for real?
It's a bug from a computer virus. The virus is rewriting the data. It has a hit point that's infinite.
This is the one.
You must escape while I buy some time.
Because of this thing, I'll kill you!
No! You can't kill it! Leave it be.
You just said its hit points are infinite and you're level one. So you're gonna charge at it.
The book. Open the book.
The book?
Yes.
The power it holds can bring forth either salvation or destruction at the whim of the user.
Book of the Twilight. And you get much better colors now, I think. I definitely think the red looks much better than the green. And data drain! We got a virus core, nice.
Like the time when Orca.
That skill. Now, I understand. You are the same as the virus. To think that I was saved by someone like you.
I don't know where that logic came from.
That's not... I don't even know what's...
Do not lie to me. Recently, many places within the world have been damaged by a virus. Those who willfully spread the virus and destroy this world for their own amusement, they...
And where did you think he was spreading the virus?
No, that's not me,
I did not expect to find the one responsible so soon. Draw! Draw your sword, now!
I won't! There's no reason to do that!
There is for me.
No! I don't want to fight! I...
What is the matter with you? That's hardly the way to talk to someone who just saved your life!
It is funny how they kind of, like, talk and act like it would be, real life. They just saved your computer life. Although, considering you can go into a coma.
Think this through. But if I find out that you are indeed in with them, I will kill you.
That was rather childish for Balmonk of the Azure Sky, the descendant of Fianna.
I do not speak with hackers.
Yep.
I thought he would end up like Orca, and I panicked. That's when I heard her voice. It was the voice of the girl who gave the book to Orca.
Yep, Aura.
I see. But what are you going to do if the data bug shows up again? That power put your friend...
I don't even know what this power is. what she wanted Orca to do.
Well, she's trying to give the bracelet to Orca, but...
this power. All I want to do is help Orca.
Alright, so... I'm guessing since I just got the bracelet, I have a feeling we're gonna run into Mia.
Well, I've gotta go. Today was... I don't know what to say, but... Good night.
Game over is no problem now? Okay. I'm gonna log out. And we'll just see what new information's popped up to get an idea of what I'm supposed to do next.
The message I posted is deleted.
These are hard. Like this, that's something that you do actually at the end of the game. I just remember it being really hard, and there's one for each game. So when you go to Mutation, Outbreak and Quarantine. See what's in the news. The World for Idiots. So she's telling me about data drain and the importance of it.
She knows about my bracelet.
Oops. And then, yeah, you respond to people's emails, and then depending on your answer or how you reply to them, you can actually, you know, build a stronger relationship with that character. At least that's how it is in GU. I think that's how it's done in this one. It has been so long. Only playing through the, you know, these games once, but it probably takes close to like 80 hours to get through all four games. If you're doing everything, or like majority of the game through it.
Is it possible to edit like that?
Mia.
A cat? Oh yeah, I saw it too. I prefer bunny girls though.
Bunny girls. I wonder where I should go. The nice thing is, if I really wanted to, I could just, you know, yeah, pick a random word, go there. Although, level 17, I would probably die in one hit. But yeah, you can just go to random worlds whenever you want, go level up. Which is the, you know, really cool part about this game. How it's just kind of open world.
Hey! I've got a great area that's full of aromatic grass. Wanna go?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, let's get ready then.
That's a unique bracelet. Can I take a look?
Can you see it?
Yes, of course. Do you mean to say you can't see this nice bracelet? even if you can't see it. As long as you know it's there, it's the same thing as seeing it, right?
Bracelet? Hey, what are you talking about? I can't see any bracelet, Mina.
Well, thanks a lot for letting me look at your bracelet. I have a feeling.
The thing is, yeah, she's a cat, but then she has really big ears, at least. Looks almost, you know, more like bunny ears, but then that's definitely not a bunny tail.
Wait, Mia! What about the aromatic grass?
But Mia's definitely a cool character. Probably at this point should log out. See if there's any more messages. Sometimes it's out of the game, you just gotta log out, log back in, and get new keywords. But I just love the storyline for the game. It's just very in-depth. Okay, yeah, new stuff on the board. Lots of new stuff. Nice. Some good keywords, which is definitely nice. Yeah, keyword creation, words for beginners. Nothing new. I think before I go anywhere, I'm definitely going to make sure I save, because if you don't save and then you lose, that's it. Like, you go back to your last save. If you don't save at all, and it's game over, then it's game over. You got to start the entire game over. So it's definitely recommended to save frequently. You can only save in town or on your desktop. Alright, so let's see if anyone's available for a party. I can invite Black Rose. So we have a protected area, on the board with the ghost. Go there, that's level 3. I just want to see what virus cores they want for the protected area. Since you have the bracelet, yeah, you can gate hack. Oh, 2 M's. Alright then, let's go to the beginners. We'll go to the beginner board, then we'll go scope out the, field, and then we'll check out the field where Aura was sighted.
fairy orb. Protection break? Yeah. So when the protection break happens, I can actually data drain them. But considering it's a level 1 enemy, there's not a major point to data draining. Whoa! I didn't realize this field was that big. That's good, I can get some levels. Try data draining. I don't have enough magic points. Okay, cool. Kite's about to level. Healed herself. The other nice thing is you can just stand still, or I think it just keeps going up if you're moving too, but it goes faster if you stand still, but your SP always just keeps recharging. So I know there were times when I would be playing and would just run out of SP and then would just wait. Nice, level up! And then you can give equipment to your, other people. So let's see, one defense and one evasion for one magic defense and a lot of magic effect. I think I will take that. Plus it ups whatever the heart is. Ooh, and they just gave us a chest. I believe that's just like a magic spell. Fire Tempest. Those are always good, the speed charms, yeah. And then these are interesting. There's lots of just like items around that'll just say whatever. Like you heard there, he said spiky cactus. There's like mandragoras and cherries and all kinds of stuff. Definitely gonna run out of fortune wires at this rate. You got two left. I know I would typically just keep myself loaded with Sprite Ocarinas, Fairy Orbs, and Fortune Wires, because they're just always good to have, just so you can see what's going on in the dungeon. You can obviously get chests, and you can warp out if need be. Speed Charms are good too. I'm trying to remember where you can purchase them. Whoa! That was a close one. Yay, Black Rose leveled. More Fire Tempests. Ooh. I'm trying to remember what that is. Okay, Magic Defense. I tried Data Draining. Data Draining a level 1 enemy. Keep missing, and so I need to work on accuracy, which accuracy's always been a problem in like MMOs. Wow. Did a lot of damage to him. Magic accuracy's up. I'd rather have physical at this point. The death. That's another spell. I don't even remember what that does. I think it's mainly like a status effect. Nice! Now I can equip that armor. Red, it's heavy body armor, twin blade, long arm, and wave master. So I will give that to Black Rose as soon as she hits level 3, which should hopefully be soon. Couple more of these portals, and then we can head to the dungeon. my last fortune wire. Miss, 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 miss. Yeah, out of fortune wires, so sadly can't get that chest. Some sniper rings. Was it? Sniper rings were, I think, level for Final Fantasy XI, which was MMO that I've played the most. I think they were level 40 rings. They were expensive too. It was like everyone wanted them. It was like 5 or 10 accuracy. They were, you know, like the big accuracy rings for a long time. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hold up! Don't die, Black Rose! Nice! Whew! That was a close one.
Yeah? What?
Actually, what do you have to trade? Just a speed charm? No.
Yeah, I'll take it.
You didn't equip it? Do I have to tell you to equip it? Maybe I... Wow.
Yeah? What's up?
I guess then you automatically equipped it? I thought it tells you if she equipped it. So, what is your equipment, yeah, then? So you have headgear.
Yeah.
Okay, so no point in giving you that since it's the same thing that you have. Alrighty then. Dungeons. It's like you're inside a creature or something, I think. Yeah, definitely weird dungeons in this game. And then, yeah, here's an egg. Nothing in there. This is more, you know, like food to collect for grunties. Something just seems wrong about a bloody egg. Does not sound appetizing. I'm gonna use some of these items, try and I got another bloody egg. It's definitely good to have for the grunties. Nice, getting good, just consumable items. Wait, so they restore every time? Seems so. So just leave, come back, and do that to get items. But is it just the bodies? Because I didn't see the egg come back. Small eggs. The death. Come on. There we go. I need to get something to definitely improve my accuracy, because it's really bad right now. Hopefully we'll have enough items to make some trades when we get back into town. Okay, don't want to go down just yet. Check whatever the map is up top. Should have probably used Sprite Ocarina. Or not a Sprite Ocarina, a Fairy Orb. So I could see the map. These things. I'm just gonna use another one of... Meteor storms. It is nice for in GU. It looks like the eggs do come back. Well, at least the small eggs. But in GU, a lot of, like, the spells, they're actually, like, quick buttons. So it's not like this, so every time you have to go into a menu. That honestly is one of the biggest downfalls of this game. Is just how menu-heavy driven it is. If they could have gotten away from that, it would have been a much better game. And I think it would have been much more received much better. Before I start jumping around this area, let me use, Fairy Orb. This is a big dungeon. Whew. Oh, man. Like I said, I do not like, mage goblins. Right. the lovers. So we're poisoned. Not that I'm too concerned about poison. It sucks, but... nice later when you get like a lot of the spells that can remove status effects. And I wish I had more of those wires to get these chests. Especially this early in the game, you want to get as many items as possible. Another Fire Tempest. That is a good spell, though. Seems to do a lot of damage. Thanks when you just see miss, 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 miss. Nice. Congrats, Black Rose. Sweet. I didn't even realize I hit level 4. Sweetness. Lots of breakable objects in this room. More of these guys. At least, yeah, if you can get them in one hit, they're not bad. Just want to see what I get from the moth. Data drain him. Got a virus core, nice. Now you gotta be careful about data draining. You don't want to data drain too quickly. Water elements are effective against fire. Thanks, Black Rose. I wouldn't have known that otherwise. But, it shows your infection level over there. Since I'm in blue, it's good. The higher it goes, you have a higher chance of just the game being over. If your character gets infected, it's just game over. The funny thing is, there's actually like a way later dungeon. Actually, I think it's after you beat the game. It's like a bonus dungeon they give you. You go in there, and you have to data drain. Like, you have no choice but to data drain, because you can't kill the enemies unless you data drain them. And the funny thing is, you'll be at, like, max infection. You'll be, like, red, and it's telling you, like, it's basically game over if you data drain. But you have to. You have to do it, like, four times when you're completely red. It's crazy. And there's just no way around it. It's just luck. There, I remember going through that dungeon and just... you just lose. And it's like, you just have to start over and you just have to cross your fingers every time you data drain. Should probably start using skills. I haven't really done that. Your Black Rose. That shouldn't really help. Miss. And I'm still poisoned, really?
Bloody eggs.
Luckily, both of us aren't poisoned, because that's just going to slow us down even more. Wow, how... beginner dungeon, but it's pretty big. Oh, harpies. I don't like them. Chicken wing. Or chicken hand. Wow, I can breathe. And he had to poison us again. Lame. Cure me now? Don't think it's that you're in that much danger, Black Rose. You know what? I don't even really feel like dealing with you guys. Whoop. I'm getting good XP from these guys. Like, I'm starting on level 4 and getting 60. I'm trying to remember what max XP is. There is a max XP. Like, I can just go to a random level and try and get, like, you know, higher level enemies just so I can level up fast. Nice, level up. Yeah, I'm not a fan of goblins. Painful to just keep seeing miss. Ah, Not even gonna give you a chance to do anything, Goblin. Come here. Nice. Getting the hangman. I need to look what that actually is. That and the lovers. I should know, because I know they're in GU. Exact same spells. Or scrolls. I am shocked at how long this poison lasts. I just thought of something. That's gonna stink. I mean, this far in, I might as well stay, but I'll definitely use a speed charm to run out. Hopefully we can get a Sprite Ocarina. Good. Paralyze, that's always good. Just poison, meh. Nothing but mage goblins. At least they die fast. I think since I'm like level 4 now, accuracy isn't bad. Dungeon. That was a close one. Fire spear. Actually, hold on. If I remember correctly, do you get... Yeah, but I got a fortune wire out of it. I don't mind the MP drain. I'd rather get a Sprite Ocarina. Get them all! Nice! Make you just loop all the way around, and I think I'm gonna have to loop all the way around home just to leave. At least after this, should be able to sell some stuff and have some money. Yay! Good job, Black Rose. I think I'm gonna sell some of like this paralysis and sleep stuff. So almost on the last floor. Blue chest. Let's always get a you might always get a fortune wire from opening just like that. Oops. Yeah, as you can see, just going through, it's very menu heavy driven, but it's not even that big of a deal that it's that menu heavy driven. It's just funny that it like pauses the game because there's no way you can like stop going to my menu and everything stops for everyone at the same time, considering it's an MMO. I do find that extremely funny. Ooh, a golden egg. I have some fortune wires. I have two. Amateur blades. Yay. I already have one of them. Hopefully it'll be a good item for trading. Last floor. Pretty big floor too. Well, they weren't kidding on the board when they were saying that this was a tough dungeon. Wow. Nice. You gotta love when experience just pops up on your screen like that. Crazy chickens! And they're high evasion. Wow, this is a crazy glass floor. All those little rooms. Black Rose, you did like no damage when I took out two of the little chickens. This thing hurts. Ow! Did that do like 40 damage to me? Seems like that one might have been higher level than the other ones. Chicken hen. Now that's nice. What level am I up to now? 7? So going from level 1 to level 7 in the same dungeon, that's pretty good. To go start looking for equipment when I get back to town. Nice. Whoa. Nice. Black Rose just leveled. The heck? It's like frozen for a second. I gotta load up on fortune wires and stuff. Now I'm interested. What does the burning oil do again? Ah. So it makes your fire stronger. And I'm getting a lot of them. Then again, it's probably just because that's what the field element is. These guys again. Nice, so that's it. No more enemies! I can't remember if that even does anything. When it says all portals open. I know that means that's it. We've, you know, beat all the enemies and we need to leave if you want more, but I can't remember if it does anything beyond that. I think it does add something in your book. Ooh, I missed the chest. Because you do get bonuses. Nice. Thank you so much for giving me a Sprite Ocarina. So what's in this fossil bracer, grunt doll, and a rainbow card? So what is that? Level 11 hands. Seems good. Nice. So I'm gonna go do that one dungeon that was, they said that they saw Aura in, and then I'll probably run around, try and get some treasure, and then call it a night there. I'm still in shock because I thought there was more to do before you got this far in the story. Not that I'm very far in the story at all. Alright, let's see. Fortune wires. They're 10 each. Wait, how much? I only have 1,000 gold? I'm gonna sell all these things. Sell these two. They're nice for trading, but at this point I really need the money. Well, hi there, Black Rose. Do that just so that's taken care of. Sprite Ocarina, since that's warping us out of the dungeon. 20 should be more than enough for now. And fairy orbs, I need a fair amount of them. I don't mind spending all my money because at that point I'm stocked. Don't really need much else. I have curative items. Let's see. Sell that, but There's plenty of it. I'd rather just use it for trading. So I believe these you can get decent trade value out of. I think we're good for now. Make sure we save after doing all that progress. What's a good dungeon for newbies? So you got 7 levels just clearing it. It's a protected area. Girl, no, I'm not going to play tag. Just out of curiosity, it's a level 1? I just honestly don't even feel like trying it until later. I just remember the goblins were always a pain, and there's, like I said, there's one for each game.
I came after reading the board, but the operator turned me back. I guess we can't play here.
Gonna head to the dungeon. Another weird dungeon. More oh no melons. Let's see, is there administrator? Yeah.
Thank you for playing the world. This area is currently unstable and not functioning properly due to corrupted data configurations. Please return to the field immediately and gate out to the town.
No, if I give up now, I'll never be able to help him.
Can you just bypass him? That's hilarious. They're like, you shouldn't be here. Just go back and gate out. You'd think they would, like, block it somehow, but... Just go back. We don't care if you just walk right by us, but just go back. Safety shoes. I need to go to a higher level area so I can get some higher level gear. Thinking when that distortion's going off, that I can get an item out of it, because you can do that in GU. Late in the game, they give you a function that allows you to access items, and you get the distortion when you're near one of them.
Yeah.
more safety shoes. At least I'm getting a good amount of items so I can trade. Although, what's my count? Okay, 25 out of 40. Nice. So I have regen refresh, basically. Still having accuracy issues. Hangman. Rose, what are you doing? Standing there twiddling your thumbs while I'm, you know, hitting the enemy. Ooh. The chest back here. Just keep getting scrolls. Give me some gear. Give me some upgraded gear. Having this regen is helping a lot. Oh, boss fight? Huh. What level is this field? Although, yeah, level 3. Whenever you get that, yeah, area like that, you get a boss fight. So this is probably gonna get where I get my other M. What? Wow. Wow. That's the other thing. Ooh. Mm-hmm. these enemies? Ooh, hold on. Dang. You can, they won't go below 50%. They don't really have any health until you data drain them. There we go, protection break. And this should give me the M virus core. Which would allow me to hack that one gate. And that was a C. Huh. I'd rather get the experience at this point than worrying about data draining him again. Although, only 40 XP.
Wow! Cool! I can't believe you defeated the monster by rewriting its data! How did you do that? Oh! Did I hit a nerve? Should I keep my mouth shut?
Probably, but... Gotta love the faces.
Well, anyway, it seems strange things have been happening everywhere. Ever since the server failure, it's all going downhill. There's something going on.
Really?
What?
Burning dinner's never good. I'll admit, I've burned dinner quite a few times because I was busy, got caught up in MMO, but... Really? Aww. I was hoping to get to the, statue. Oh, no. Oh, Lord, help me. Oh. And this is by far what I think is the worst part of the game. You trust someone's eyes in an online video game.
A player I know is being harassed by a wicked monster in Delta, Indiscreet Gluttonous Pilgrimage.
Okay.
I will vanquish the wicked monster, and I want you to bear witness.
Why do you need me to bear witness?
You will do that for me?
No.
You will? I knew you would say that. I will be waiting for you at Delta Indiscreet Gluttonous Pilgrimage. This will be good.
And sadly, you have to do it to continue the game. Yeah. Kite's expression says it all. Yeah, not doing that now. Do you have anything to trade worth value? Ooh. I will take these and let's see if All right. What? Why did you not trade? Yes. I guess maybe it does it automatically after it's full. Really? 11 burning molehills and 2 health drinks for a weapon. But okay. The trades you can do in this are weird, but... since it's not a real person, I don't really feel bad about ripping them off, since they're okay with it. So now I got Dark Dance and just straight upgrade, except for I'm losing light. I think that's light. I don't know what element that is, but go get the menu out. I want to see. There we go. Those are weird blades. They look like anchors. But let's see if I can find armor or something else. Phantom blades. That's low level. Raise dark close blow. Oh, that's scroll. You don't have anything worth treating. I already saw you. Let's probably look for a weapon for Black Rose. Change equipment. What do you have? That's a level one. So let's get her an upgraded weapon. Sure, you can have the two crappy safety shoes. All right, Belle. Do you have anything? Fine, I will trade you the weapon I just traded. That works. Whoa, Black Rose, come back!
Yeah?
Yes, take this item.
Yeah, I'll take it.
I thought they equipped it.
Yeah?
What? Why does she not? Oh, did I just buy it for a blade master, not a heavy blade? I think I'm getting classes confused and just throwing money away. Here, Black Rose. Where is she? You should still have the item. Water element parameter plus one. I don't even know if this is. Yeah, like. Yeah, they're not even willing to trade for it. Okay, so Blade Master Heavy Blade. Okay, so I need to make sure. It's the right item. You're trying to train with Belle. Who are you? Have I seen you before?
4, 7, 2, and 2. Four, eight, two, two, so no. All swords for blade masters, nothing for heavy blades. Saw you. Here we go. Some people down here to try and trade. I think the guys they always have down here generally have like something that will boost your parameters. Yeah. Nice. Level 6 sword.
Yeah?
Sorry, here you go.
Yeah, I'll take it.
There we go, equipped. Nice new sword. I like it. Cool design on it, too. I'm not a big fan of my current weapon. So it looks like I have anchors on my hands. And yeah, you could run around all day trading items and stuff. That's what I have. Nothing else. Alright, I think we're good. I'm gonna go ahead and call it quits here. I will continue this, but I'm going to break it up into Let's Plays. Next week for my live stream, I plan on doing Mega Man X1 for the SNES. Definitely a classic game. But I hope you enjoyed this playthrough of this Let's Play of Dot Hack. Be sure to check out my other videos as I'm bringing out more of this game. And I'll probably do a live stream when I get to Mutation. Probably do one at the beginning of each of them. Might even do a live stream to end it all when I finally get there, but that's way down the road. But until next time, may you have success in all you do.